Hi there, I'm Mike.
And I'm Chris. Today we're gonna show you how you can use a budget CNC like the 3018 to cut and engrave acrylic plastic.
We're gonna share our techniques and settings for how we make pieces like this Raspberry Pi Zero case. And also how we make acrylic logo lights.
The 3018 CNC is not the fastest one, nor is it the strongest one, but it's a very capable machine, and cutting and engraving acrylic plastic is quite easy if you use the right tools, materials, and feed rate.
Recommended speeds for cutting acrylics is about 15 to 18,000 RPM, but a 3018 with its 24 volt power supply can only do 7,000 RPM. But that's not going to be too much of a problem if you follow our steps.
First, let's start with the materials. Acrylics comes in two versions, cast and extruded.
When acrylic is extruded, it's forced into its current shape. This leaves a lot of tensions, which makes the material more brittle and prone to shattering. That's why cast acrylics are easier to machine.
But even more important is that you buy acrylics and not a different kind of plastic. The reason why this is so important is that different type of plastic has different melting temperatures. Regular acrylics has a melting point at 160 degrees Celsius or 320 degrees Fahrenheit. If the melting point is lower, you will have plastic melting on your bit and the bit will break very easily.
We usually buy plexiglass that is 30 by 30 centimeters. This is the same width as the work area of the 3018. It's longer, but it allows us to maximize what we get out of each sheet.
Second is the bit you use. You want a bit that chips off plastic and not just piles.
If you end up with filing instead of chipping, you're going to heat up the acrylic and the bit. This is just going to cause everything to melt.
So if you use a bit with single or double flute and a reasonable spiral rate, you're off to a good start. It can also be easier when you're starting out to use a bit with a little bit larger diameter.
There are special bits made for acrylics. These are often a bit more expensive. So we're gonna leave a couple of links in the description to some cheaper options that's gonna perform very well.
Third is the feed rate and how fast the CNC is traveling. If the feed rate is too slow, you will end up melting the acrylics, and this will lead to poor edges and possibly a broken bit, and you might destroy the piece you work on.
The feed rate is dependent on the bits and the RPM of the spindle. On the 3018, the RPM is set, so if you're using an OK bit, you only need to fine-tune the feed rate as well as the cut depth.
To allow for an OK feed rate, you cannot cut too deep at each pass. Although it will take longer time, it will make your job easier.
This is a fairly safe feed rate and depth for our 3mm bit with two flutes.
As you get more experienced, you can play with the feed rate and the depth.
By listening to your CNC and looking at the chip size, you can find optimal settings for your setup.
But this takes some practice, so you better start off safe.
If you found this video helpful, please leave a like. It really helps the channel.
And remember to subscribe.